mark the beginning of the Indian Removal Act, which was when Indians removed from their land onto land that the settlers did not want to settle. The move from Indians from their land to areas in Nebraska, Kansas, and Oklahoma was called the Trail of Tears. And following the Trail of Tears in 1851, the Indian Appropriations Act was made. This was where all states were allowed to make Indian reservations, which ended up putting Indians on inhabitable land. This led to many uprisings and many Indian wars, because even though the Indians were able to govern themselves, they were dying from starvation and poverty and little to no economic growth. Ulysses S. Grant saw this as a problem, and so in 1868, he made a policy that would help assimilate Indians into the American culture. Although this idea sounds good, it was ultimately a bad idea. During this time, Indians were stripped of their culture, their religion, and even their language. And Indians were getting very upset by this, and they started getting very irritated, which led to uprisings and a lot of unrest. In the 1930s, FDR saw the good intentions of Grant's policy, but he also saw that it was ultimately harming the Indians. And so in the 1930s, FDR established the United States Indian Recognition Act, which allowed Indians to go back to governing themselves and allowed them to gain their culture and their values back. Although a lot of things happened in the 1830s and 1930s, it's still affecting the Indians today and how they are living and how their culture works. So this is a map of all of the Indian reservations in America, and there is one in particular that I would like to talk about tonight. This is the Fort Washakie Indian Reservation in Wind River, Wyoming. And for the past 4 years, I have been going there on a mission trip to hold VBS for the kids and help out around the area and help out in their schools. And I've met a lot of amazing and wonderful kids through this, and I would like to share a few of their stories tonight. So this is Lawrence. He is 6 years old, and he is such a fun-loving, amazing kid. And for the past 4 years that I've been going on this mission trip, I've seen Lawrence every single time. And when he was born, he lived with his parents, but he lost both of them at an early age to alcoholism. And after that, he was living with his grandfather, who was his last living relative. And Lawrence loved his grandfather, and he would always talk about his grandfather and talk about how much fun that they would have. And I asked him last year, I said, "Lawrence, how's your grandfather doing?" And he told me, "My grandfather froze to death walking back from the casino drunk." I was shocked. I couldn't believe that a five-year-old was telling me in detail how his grandfather died. And since then, Lawrence has been bouncing around from unfit foster home to unfit foster home. All of these kids are still affected by the acts in the 1900s and 1800s today. Another girl that I met, her name is Paris, and apparently the pictures aren't up there, but her name is Paris, and she didn't really like her picture being taken, so I had to sneak a few pictures in. Paris, I met her for the first time this year, and she is an amazing kid. She loves basketball, and she has 4 younger siblings. And the more I talked with Paris, the more she opened up to me, and she told me about how her mother had passed away a few months earlier. Her mother was a nurse, and her father was a drug addict. Her father was arguing with her because he wanted her to give him drugs, and when she refused, he shot her in front of Paris and her 4 siblings. These kids on these reservations are being exposed to the darkness of this world at such a young age. When I step onto that reservation, I feel like I'm stepping into a third world country on American soil, and that's very heartbreaking because you look around and you see the trailer homes that they live in with boarded up windows and doors hanging off by one hinge, and that's what they call home. When we interfered with their life, we messed it up for future generations. And there are people like you and me that need to go and help them and show these kids the love and care that they need to be better citizens. Thank you.